A wild ride on the stock market this week. Thanks for staying with us tonight. I'm Christiane Klein.
And I'm Brian Loftus. Tuesday, we told you about the Dow plunging 799 points, which was the worst day in about 2 months.
Well, today, it dropped 785 more points, but then rallied back to make up for much of today's losses. And joining me tonight to talk about what's behind all this volatility is Andrew Whalen with Whalen Financial here in Las Vegas. Thank you for coming in to
Thank
talk
you.
About this.
My pleasure.
I want to start tonight with China. Mm-hmm. There are concerns about an escalating trade war, concerns mm-hmm. about tariffs, mixed messages from mm-hmm. the White House and Beijing on about that. And then we have that announcement today about the arrest of the Chinese tech executive from a huge company, Huawei, sure. which actually sells more smartphones than Apple.
Right.
So how much of what we're seeing on Wall Street is because of what's happening with China and the U.S.?
I think it has a lot to do with it. Specifically with regards to China, I think there's two distinct factors. With regards to China, you've got the trade war on the direct effects, the direct cost, what's going to happen to the consumer, and also the indirect effects, meaning how far is this going to go? Mm-hmm. Are we going to go into a full-blown trade war? Is that going to affect the overall U.S. economy? And what are the ramifications if the White House can't get something solved? And I think right now that's what the market's really trying to price in.
And we're going to have volatility about that until we get those answers as well.
Yes, and volatility is absolutely normal. It's a normal functioning part of the U.S. stock market. It tells us that it is healthy when we do see volatile times, but the best thing to do is to remain calm and not be a panic seller.
I want to talk also about the bond market. There are some concerns about the yield curve, which mm-hmm. has indicated problems with recessions before. What are we seeing now, and should we be worried?
I don't think that this time is a little bit more unique than in past because we've had so much quantitative easing over the last 8 years. So I'm not too much worried about an inversion of the yield curve is what the topic of the headline is out of the news today. But I would be worried that if the Fed doesn't step in and take ramifications with regards to defining a more clear path with rising interest rates.
And investors always want to know what the Fed's going to do. What do you think that's going to happen?
I think that they will most likely hike in December, but the one reason why the market rallied today was primarily because the Fed came out and said that they see the rates at near neutral. And why that's a good sign is because that they're giving at least the markets and Wall Street a leading indicator on the direction that they're going to take with interest rates next year. Because as they rise interest rates, or as they raise interest rates, I'm sorry, that affects asset prices across the board. So as interest rates have risen, we've seen asset prices as far as housing, as far as home loans, as far as auto loans and small business loans start to damper because of that additional cost of rising interest rates.
Okay, we can talk about this all day long.
Yes.
Definitely want to talk to you coming up here as well about the federal deficit too, whether or not that could be a problem.
And the trade war is going to have a big impact on that. What is the Fed or what is the United States going to do with regards to trade with China, and how is that going to impact the increasing federal deficit? I don't think it's so much of a problem right now because of the fiscal stimulus that's come from the increased tax spending and the tax relief that we saw from the policy that was passed earlier this year. But at the end of the day, I think the deficit's not going to be that big of a problem.
Okay. Andrew Whalen, thanks for joining us today.
Thank you.
Brian?
Good information there. Thank you both.